as Dean of this cathedral, may I add my welcome to you all, along with that of the Vice Dean given a little earlier. In these holy and uncertain days, we welcome you in the name of God, who has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and made a place for us in the kingdom of his beloved Son. We meet to celebrate anew the coming of God's kingdom and long for the days when we can be close once more to those we know and love. Here we will hear revealed the mystery of God's loving purpose for us, how that when we were far off, he met us in his Son and brought us home, how he humbled himself to take our human nature, that we might share his divine glory. Let us then celebrate this coming with hope renewed through our carols of praise, so that our lives may be charged with Christ's life, that we may bear witness to his glory and so bring light to those who dwell in darkness. First, we pray for those among whom the Christ was born, the poor and the helpless, the aged and the young, the hungry and the homeless, the victims of poverty and injustice, unemployment and oppression, the sick, their carers, and those who mourn, the lonely, the unloved, those in despair or in the shadow of death. Then, as we hear again the message of peace on earth and goodwill among all God's people, we pray for the leaders of the nations, that all may be inspired to work together for the establishment of health, justice, healthcare, and vaccines for all, and also for freedom and peace the world over. And that we may bear true witness to this hope in a divided world, we pray too for the peace and unity of Christ's body, the Church Universal, that the whole earth may live to praise his name. Finally, as we rejoice with the saints in heaven and on earth, we remember all who have gone before us with the sign of faith, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom we offer up our prayers for the coming of his perfect kingdom, in the words he himself has taught us, as we say together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. The sound of the Lord God walking about in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and they hid from him among the trees. The Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He replied, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." God said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree which I forbade you to eat from?" The man replied, "It was the woman you gave to be with me who gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate it." The Lord God said to the woman, "What have you done?" The woman answered, "It was the serpent who deceived me into eating it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed alone of all cattle and the creatures of the wild. On your belly you will crawl, and dust you will eat all the days of your life. I shall put enmity between you and the woman, between your brood and hers. They will strike at your head, and you will strike at their heel." Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord called to Abram a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice." Thanks be to God.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to God.
from the stock of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp. And the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
The angel Gabriel was sent to God to a town, sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth to Galilee, to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace amongst those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. Thanks be to God.
King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least amongst the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is shepherd to my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Thanks be to God.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived amongst us. And we have seen his glory, the glory of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
As we stand, we pray. Almighty God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, so we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Just wanted to say a few thank yous. A thank you to those who made the beautiful music. Thank you for that. Thank you to Dean Tim and the clergy team. Thank you to the vergers and the servers and the sound desk and the volunteers and those in the office and the people I've forgotten who will now be very grumpy. Most of all, thank you to you for coming and joining us as we tell this story of Christmas and as we worship. And I hope that it has set you up for a very joyful Christmas. Please bow your heads as we pray for God's blessing. Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of the divine nature, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.